Welcome. Today we will talk about the Buddha philosophy. Now, this is a part of Indian logic, Indian darshan that we talk about. And what we would be understanding, as we have seen in the previous classes, there were two sects, the orthodox and the heterodox. Heterodox were the ones who did not believe in Vedas. Under heterodox, we had the three major categories and one minor category. So the three major categories were Charavak, Buddha, Jain, and then one minor category, which was Ajivika. So today we would be focusing on the Buddha philosophy. Just to give you a recap of the four philosophies, Charavaks did not believe in afterlife. Their only objective was what is present is there, and perception is something that's really important. Buddha philosophy we would be pursuing. Jaina philosophy pursued on the karma, and then you had the karma and ahimsa. And the last philosophy, that was a minor philosophy, Ajivika, was basically led by Mahakali Gosala, and the idea was they were basically wandering sects who were talking about the developments, and they were far away from the ideas of Ved. So the Ved philosophy or the concepts, the beliefs under Ved was not very, very important under them. The next important thing that we would understand is, now when we talk about the Buddha philosophy that was laid down by Gautam Buddha was born in Lumbini, and on one of the occasions, he was born in a palace. So in one of the occasions that were held in the palace, he realized that there is something that is not real, or that's something that's missing around in this whole occasion that's going on. So he could not sleep at that night. At the night, he asked his one of his most faithful servants, Chana, to take the horse, the white horse, which was Kanthak, his horse, ready, and he would be going into the vicinities and seeing what life is, exploring about life. After that, when he went around, he went a little far, and then he asked Chana to return back. Chana insisted that he was one of his most faithful servants and he wanted to be with him, but Gautam Buddha said that this would be my final journey away from the home, and I do not want to take you anyone along. So after subsequent refusals of Chana, Gautam Buddha convinced Kanthak, the horse, and Kanthak took back Chana. But as soon, the mythology says, or the history says, as soon as Gautam Buddha was away from his eyes, he died of sorrow. So that was the life of Kanthak that has been described. Now, when Gautam Buddha was trying to explore life, there were three things that significantly affected him, and that brought him to a notion that life is suffering. Those three things were, first, a sick person, second, a old person, and third, a dead person. And based on these three things, he believed that life is suffering, and what we need to do is we need to find the happiness within to rule out those sufferings. So all his teachings have been concised basically in the three patikas that have been called as Sutta Patika, Vinay Patika, and Abhidharma Patika. Sutta Patika are basically the tales, Vinay Patika are the disciplines, and Abhidharma Patika are basically the scholastic achievements that are there. All his teachings were based on Upanishads and emphasized strongly on the idea of karma or action. According to him, this karma is the only cause of birth and rebirth that takes place. So inference is the source of all valid knowledge that he propounded, and everything revolved around the karma. To lay down his idea that life is suffering, he talked about the eightfold path to achieve happiness, and that was having a right faith within yourself, taking the right resolution to work around something, speaking the right word, taking the right action, having a correct living, good thoughts, a right concentration, and finally an effort for that thing that you want to pursue. So these eightfold paths led to four noble truths that he talked about, and under his four noble truths he said, firstly, there is suffering that is present everywhere. What we need to understand is the nature of the suffering. What is the kind of that suffering that is present? Why this suffering came? So the origin of the suffering, the cessation of the suffering or the end of the suffering is again important. And finally, the path to end that suffering. So part to end that suffering was important. And that was again a noble truth that was propounded by God, the Buddha philosophy. This Buddha philosophy basically emphasized on metaphysics, epistemology and ethics. It was far away from the ideas of Ved. And this talked about the science of karma or the action. So the deeds were really, really important. So this was a kind of summary of the Buddha philosophy. We would be covering many important topics under your logic, the newly added syllabus. For details, you can just check down the description below. Have a wonderful day ahead.